Hi, Alexander. I hope you can hear me okay. Yeah. Well, good, good. And it's been a really interesting hour listening to your contributors. I have visited India on a number of occasions as Economy Minister for Northern Ireland, and I'm really interested in ongoing and indeed renewed links between the different regions of the United Kingdom and India. And as a region, and we've already mentioned fintech and cybersecurity, and of course, Northern Ireland has expertise in both of those areas. And of course, we have the youngest population per head of population. How does the panel see regions of the United Kingdom, and Northern Ireland in particular, of course, playing their part in the UK vision, if you like, of this renewed partnership, which, by the way, I very much welcome?
Thank you very much indeed. And thank you so much to all the panelists. The High Commissioner, UK High Commissioner, Mr. Ellis, mentioned the question of conservation. And I wondered whether the panelists could suggest some practical measures in which this could begin, particularly trying to set up innovative partnerships with countries in sub-Saharan Africa. I mean, is it just a question of venture capitalists, or are there other mechanisms that could be pursued? Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me?
Hello.
Okay, good. I was hearing this conversation very keenly. It was a very, very interesting conversation. My question is related to the UK-India trade relations. It was mentioned in passing by the UK High Commissioner, Alice, in terms of trade and investment. There has been a discussion in the past India FTA. Now, if you look at the background of the EU-India FTA negotiations when Britain was a member of EU, is some of the problems were actually coming from Britain. For example, movement of natural persons or the duties on whiskey and so on. And what are the red lines and how do you think we can overcome them? This is a question to anybody in the panel, including both the Excellency, the High Commissioners.
Oh, thank you very much. Fantastic presentations today, absolutely fascinating. But my question, I think the obvious synergy between both countries in technology, environmental, geopolitical has been really militarily, tourism, cultural. But the question that I think I'd be interested to hear about is what the role of the Commonwealth is. We haven't really, obviously a lot of changes with the monarchy in this country, unfortunately, recently. So just what is the status and how can that be perhaps reinvigorated and re-energized as part of this relationship? Thank you.
Thank you.